While you're turning, let me just say I've been in a series of messages for some weeks now on success, and today is true success. But next week, the Lord willing, I'm going to be preaching on the subject of Solomon's prayer for wisdom. You need to make plans and hear this message. God can use it to not only instruct and enlighten your life, but He will bring to you a new dimension of spiritual understanding. Jesus, in the upper room, just prior to the time of His passion, Jesus said to His disciples, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." Peace is the most fragile commodity known to man. We're living in a day where men are crying, "Peace, peace," and there is no peace. We're living in a day where most of us reside in a world of relative peace. Everything looks good right now. But I want you to know that one experience can come to your world and your peace will be gone. Your world will be thrown into turmoil. For instance, let's say that tomorrow you go into your job and they say, "We don't need you." And your world is thrown into a turmoil. The peace that you have had is suddenly gone. Or you go to the doctor, and the doctor, with a sad expression on his face, says, "I'm sorry, I suspect, I think." And your peace is suddenly shattered. All of those things that you had banked on, counted on, suddenly is gone. Many today who are living on fixed incomes and who had banked on their golden years suddenly find their nest egg eroded because of an economy that has gone sour. And with that happening, they don't know what to do, and they've lost their peace. Families begin to come unglued. And one of the saddest things in life is to see a family where there's been a wonderful fellowship and relationship for years and years, but then something happens and that family turns on one another. Their peace is shattered. Well, you can name 10